Hello my friends and welcome to Pinnacle Photography. Today I have come to my rooftop of my apartment to produce the second part of my video that was hugely popular and that was posted almost more than 1.5 years ago, and I thought that the second part will be useful to you. Those who have not seen that previous video, you can go to the above link and see the first part of the video. And today I will discuss about the second part, that is manual shooting with the Nikon B700 camera, that is the advanced photography with that compact zoom bridge camera. Who cannot afford bigger lenses or expensive cameras, land lenses, they can also do birding with this camera. And this is just enjoyable. Shooting is enjoyable and you can see many birds. At least you can see good colors and good pictures. Not as good as DSLR level, but still you can shoot good pictures of the bird. So let's do it. So I will discuss about the various settings that I will use for bird shooting in this camera, Nikon B700. And obviously in manual mode, that you can see. But for now I'll shoot birds, and please continue to watch and I'll discuss about the settings at the end of this video. So now we can see there are lot of trees around, and those trees are full of birds. Today I'm seeing lot less than other day, but still I will find birds. Mostly common birds, backyard birds like bulbuls, spotted dove, and sometimes jungle myna, jungle babbler. But still I can practice with that camera shooting birds, and you can too. Also, before going to the jungle, real jungle, real field, I think that will be more easier for you and more appropriate for you. Just see around for birds. I can see one spotted dove, but slightly far from here. But I cannot show you. I'm trying to show you. The problem with this camera is during video shooting it cannot focus easily, so that is a big problem. It's unlike other modern cameras or DSLR or mirrorless, as you know, that can focus very fast, and usually those cameras don't hunt. But this camera hunts a lot during focusing. So it's just flew away. So I cannot show you in the video. Now let's try for another bird. Sunlight is a little harsh for me. Perhaps I am late. I should have come at least 1 hour earlier in the morning. So it's around 7 a.m. I should have come here at least 6:30 a.m. if not 6 a.m. So there is one dove at the attic. Perhaps you can hear the sound. One rule for bird photography is keep your bird in such a way that always sun is behind you. In this case, I cannot keep the sun behind me, and it is seated in the southern part of the attic, and the sun is on my left, that means in the east, but I'm trying my best so that I just be aware. You know, it's very difficult to shoot birds with video camera in one hand and B700 in another hand, because I have to balance my camera to make it steady with the hand, and I'll show you how later, so that it's not moving. Though it has wear, but it's still important. I'm trying to take a picture of sunbird, but it is very less. For that reason, I'm missing it. I've seen one teeth. Just take it. Oh, I got quite a few shots, but I don't know how they came, because in this harsh sunlight and in my display, I cannot examine how it is, so I had to examine that picture in a big screen, that is my laptop screen. But I think it is okay, not very good, not so much sharp, but I think it will be good enough for sharing. Now, smaller birds are very fast, and you have to keep the shutter speed very high, and in this camera the limitation is that I cannot go above 1,000 second, because your ISO will not support. If you go above ISO 400, then picture quality will degrade. And I have tried several birds with ISO 800, and picture quality is not adequate. That means at least for sharing is not adequate. Now I can see the same spotted dove at the same place, and I will try to take it. I cannot show you, but I'll try to take it. That time I was trying video and I lost the bird. This time I will only take the still shot. It has some excellent wear. Now one red-vented bulbul. I'm waiting to just if flew away. Now I've seen another spotted dove over the attic. I'm trying to take this picture. Oh my god, it has come nearer. Okay. Come on. It's moving. Making a peculiar sound. Oh, there are two. Oh, then it flew away. I have taken some decent shots of that spotted dove, but they are far away. I don't know whether I'll be able to see the details. I have seen one woodpecker. one tip is that try to take as many shots you can, because you never know how many shots are actually that good, how many shots are clear serve. So you have to take as many shots as you can. Now I have taken lot of shots of that woodpecker, but I don't know whether it will be sharp enough. As the sun is rising up, it's giving scorching sunlight, and it's very difficult for me to roam about in the rooftop. So let's go to the other side of the rooftop. I was seeing one myna. It was so near that I was not able to focus properly. I had to decrease the zoom level, and then I was able to focus that bird. And so I first started shooting. I shot one dove, but background and surrounding things are not nice. I have to change the background. Let's go from other side. Now it's okay. It's almost 7:25. I don't have too much time. At least I want to get one red-vented bulbul. I can see one, but it's very far away, and so it's also into the dark. Sitting in the dark in the shade, so it will not be good enough. The same dove. This is against light. Today I am not seeing so many birds. Yesterday there were a lot of birds here around the rooftop and all over the trees, but today there are much less, and maybe I am late today morning, so I couldn't get so many birds. I'm seeing one woodpecker try to shoot a video. We get this camera. It's very far away. I don't know how much good it will be. I'm sorry. Just be aware. Again, it's in the shade. The problem is autofocusing during video. I mean, it has moved from some other places. Okay, I have some stock photos. I'll show you some stock photos that I took with manual mode in this camera, and I will try shooting moving birds, that is bird in flight, another day. So stay tuned and please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you get the notification about my new video release. And as you know that in this channel I usually discuss about various gears, not technical reviews, but usually user reviews, and also I post various blogs, also reviews about some gadgets, interesting gadgets. So that's all for now. So my friends, enough shooting of birds, and now I'm going straight to the settings that I used for manual mode in this Nikon Coolpix V700 camera. Now first I want to discuss about some general rules for bird photography, and later I will come to the part of settings. Now first rule is the timing for birding, and as you know, birds are not found in almost all the time of the day, because they are active for some particular time, and that is 2 hours after sunrise and 2 hours before sunset. This is the main time when birds are active. So first I will discuss about the timing, and birds usually are active maximum in the morning after sunrise and before sunrise. To be specific, usually 2 hours before after sunrise and 2 hours before sunrise. So that is the time when you should try shooting birds. So you have to get up early for bird shooting and start your shooting. Now coming to the next part, that is lighting. Light is the important part of your bird photography, because light is the only medium that will produce the picture in your camera sensor. So light is very vital in this regard, and for that you have to know the light. Usually morning light and light in the dusk is preferable, but usually I shoot in the morning light, because in the dusk the light level decreases very fast. So I think in the morning light is more suitable for bird photography. Now some other rules for light. You should try to keep the bird in the sunlight, frontal sunlight, or obliquely you can keep the bird. As a rule, keep your sun behind you. That means keep the sun behind your camera so that it lights, sunlight falls on the bird and you get a good picture with more contrast and more details. So this is the thing. And next, I am coming to the next part, that is the practice. As you know that manual mode shooting is somewhat difficult than other modes like aperture priority, so it needs practice, and you should try in your backyard before going to the jungle or forest for wild birds, because usually backyard birds, they are not afraid of us, they are not afraid of the human beings, and they can come in front in very close distance. So you should try practicing bird shooting in the backyards. Better still, if you put a feeder and put some feed in that feeder in the morning, after some time birds will come and you will get plenty of opportunity to shoot birds. So practice is very important, because practice will make you perfect, and you can get the right moment and right picture. So now coming to the next part, wait for the right moment. As I was telling you, the right moment is very important for bird photography. And you can see bird eating, bird flying, bird mating, something like that. But you have to wait for the right moment. If you try shooting randomly, then you will not get the right picture for you. That will not be beautiful, that will not look beautiful. So for the right moment, you have to wait, and you have to focus the bird and wait for the right moment and press the shutter when it is right. So this is another important thing. Now next rule is, try to take as many shots as possible, because you don't know whether you have taken one or two shots, maybe that they are not so sharp, they may be they are not so clean, maybe underexposed or overexposed, something like that. So you have to try to take as many shots as possible. That will increase the probability of getting the stunning image that you want. So that is another rule. Next rule is, try to pre-focus. Now I'll go to the settings, I'll tell you how to focus birds, but even after setting all the settings, then you have to try pre-focus in some certain area, so that bird will come in that focus area and you will get the shot. This is more applicable like if you have placed a feeder in your backyard and you are pre-focusing it, so that when bird comes in the view, you can take the shot and it will be crisp and sharp. In some situations it is effective, definitely not in every situation. So that will be helpful for you pre-focusing. Now I will discuss about the setting proper. Now this is my Nikon V700 camera. I will show you the screen also. Now just I am telling. First, set the camera or mode dial to the M. Then go to the menu and scroll upwards till the first menu comes. And usually it is the image quality. I prefer to shoot in RAW. You may shoot in JPG, but I will advise you to shoot in RAW, because if you shoot in RAW, there will be more latitude in post-processing. You can tweak the image, you can increase the sharpness, you can change the white balance of the picture, and many things. You can decrease the noise level, you can increase the exposure. That is not possible with the JPG format, and there will be more information recorded in the RAW format. So I'll advise you to shoot in RAW. One thing you can do, you can shoot in the RAW plus F mode, that is RAW plus JPG fine. Fine means it is compressed in such a way that the details are not lost. So JPG fine, JPEG fine, and RAW. This is the preferable mode. Next, I'm coming to the image size. Image size is something. I'll prefer to get the large size image. In this case, this is 20 mm. 20 mm size is the adequate size. Now, next menu is picture control. I usually keep it in SD, that is standard, not neutral, not vivid. Vivid color is too strong and sharpness contrast is too strong for me. I usually keep it in standard mode. If you want more colors and more contrast, then you can keep it in vivid also. Don't go to neutral, colors are not so great. And for this bird photography, this will be adequate. Now, custom picture control, I usually do not tweak the picture control very much. I keep it as such. Now, if you want, you can change the picture control also. Customize as per your requirement. Now, coming to the white balance, I keep it usually in auto 1. Or if you keep in daylight, that will be good during the daytime, usually in the morning. But I usually keep it in auto normal, auto 1 setting, and that gives me good results. Now, coming to the metering, I keep it in usually matrix metering mode. You can see there are three modes of metering: matrix, center meter, and spot. Spot metering is handy in some situations, but not all. And I have shot many images and tested it, and I think matrix metering is the most complex and most appropriate metering for this bird photography, because it will take the metering from the whole of the scene as well as the bird in the center or in the focus area, and it will determine the exposure. And I think it is the most perfect exposure mode. So metering mode should be matrix metering. Next, coming to the next mode, that is continuous or single, like that. So I usually prefer single shot. If you want action shots of the birds, then you can shoot continuous high. It can take high FPS shot up to 120 frames per second, and I think that is not very useful because it will take up a large amount of your memory. And I usually prefer to keep it in single mode. Now, coming to the ISO sensitivity, I don't go above 400 usually. If absolutely necessary, I'll go up to 800, not more than that, because usually this sensor in this camera is 1 to 3 inch sensor, and that is very small, and it is packed with 20 megapixels. That means so many pixels are packed in that small sensor, and obviously pixel size is very small, so it can gather very less light than the DSLR or full frame equivalent camera. So you have to remember it so that you don't go ISO above 400 level. Keep it as low as possible. I usually keep it in 400 because I want to get maximum shutter speed in the manual mode, so that the pictures come sharp and not blurry. I don't have to worry if I keep it in 400. I can keep it also in 100 also, but in that case the light level should be very bright so that I can have good shutter speed. Now, coming to the AF area mode, there are lot of area mode. AF area mode, AF area means the area you want to be in focus. Don't confuse it with the other mode, that is the autofocus mode. Autofocus area is something that the area of the bird which you want to be in focus, that may be eye, maybe tail, maybe usually we keep the bird eye in the focus, sharp focus. So I keep it in the manual spot, very small area that is targeted for focusing. And if you want, if you can use manual normal also, and I will not suggest wide and subject tracking or target finding. So keep it in spot area. Next mode is autofocus mode. In this case, you can keep it in AFS single autofocus mode. That means if you focus, it will lock in that particular area, it will not go anywhere. If you set it in AF, that means full time autofocus, the camera will continue to focus if you press the shutter and keep it pressed, then it will continue to focus. And that is useful for action shots and continuous shooting. But I usually prefer single shot AF, or there is another useful AF, that is pre-focus. Sometimes you will see that, notice that whenever you try to focus, you point your camera towards a bird and bird will fly away. That happens many times. So I think this mode is very useful, pre-AF mode. Whenever you will point your camera towards a bird, it will automatically focus before even you have pressed the shutter button. So that is very useful for me, and it can be useful for you too. So use it, pre-focus mode. This is done. Next, exposure plus exposure composition. It is not needed for this daytime photography. Noise reduction filter, I keep it to the normal mode. There are three modes, high, normal and low. I usually keep it in normal mode so that there is not excessive smoothening of the picture while decreasing the noise. So sharpness will go if you keep it in high mode. So I keep it in normal. Active delighting is not very useful in this situation. I usually do not use this menu. Next, save user setting. And whatever you have set this camera, if you save user settings, you can save the settings, and you can load in the custom mode. That is here, they will see one U mode, user settings mode. You can load here, and that I will show in separate video. Next, reset user settings. You can reset all your settings by pressing this menu. Now zoom memory, this is one menu, sub menu that you can use to keep your camera lens zoomed in a certain position. That means you, if you want it is fully zoomed in, then you can keep that in position, and whenever you switch on your camera, it will automatically go to that position. You don't have to move this button beside that shutter button. There is one button to increase the zoom level and decrease the zoom level. You don't have to move that button. It will automatically go to the memory zoom position. So this is useful, but I usually do not use it, because whenever the bird may come closer to you, and at time you have to again decrease the zoom level. But it may be useful in some cases. If bird is far away, then it will be useful. Now, next menu is startup zoom position. If you have kept in the maximum zoom, then it is not needed. Now, this menu is useful if you want to keep the zoom level in certain position. You can fix it in up to 105 mm. And whenever you start your camera, it will immediately go to that position. Now, manual exposure view, I keep it on so that I can see the exposure level. The one good thing about this camera is there is electronic viewfinder, and immediately you can check whether it is underexposed or overexposed. You can have an idea about the picture, what you don't get in a DSLR. You can get it in mirrorless also, but in DSLR this facility is not available. So you can immediately check whether it is overexposed or underexposed. And if you keep this menu on, that means exposure preview, there will be one side vertical bar for exposure, and it will denote the right exposure. Middle is a zero, above is a plus, below is minus, so that exposure is increased, that is overexposed, the bar will go up. It will go up. If it is decreased, then it will go down. towards minus. So you have to keep in mind and you have to see always this bar while adjusting exposure. Now menus are all set. Now suppose I am shooting one bar there. Now I can see my exposure meter in the, as a vertical bar in the side screen, and I have to expose it properly. Now my ISO is fixed to 400. Now aperture is, I have to increase the zoom level, then I can show you. So here my aperture is 5.5 and it is overexposed, so I have to decrease the exposure to some extent. And what I do is usually I increase the shutter speed here. So it was showing overexposed, now it is showing light exposure. So I will take the shot, press the shutter button and it will be done. And this is the shooting in manual mode. That's all. So happy shooting with your Nikon B7. Hello, once again I forgot one thing to mention, and that is the balancing the camera. I have shown you in the video that I am shooting birds with this camera in one hand and video camera in the other hand. That is not recommended because you have to balance the camera. There is excellent gear in this camera, but you have to balance it like this way, like if you increase the zoom then it will be front heavy, and if it moves slightly, there is even slight amount of shake, it will be magnified. So it is better to keep this area over your palm and balance it, and then see through the viewfinder. You can either use your left eye or right eye and just press the shutter button and take the photo. That's it. So happy shooting. Bye. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you get the notification whenever I post a new video. Thank you.